maybe you're looking for cheap hair care products you can make at home. Or maybe you're concerned about the impact of detergents on the environment and so are trying to be more eco-friendly in your choice of toiletries. Or maybe you just saw someone raving about how awesome their hair looks on Instagram. Whatever the reason, if you search for natural alternatives to shampoo and conditioner, you won't get far, and by not far I mean it's the first result, before you'll find people telling you about using baking soda and vinegar to keep your hair shiny and healthy. Great, right? Cheap, eco-friendly, super easy to find. Except all those people who are raving about how amazing baking soda washing is, they're probably destroying their hair. Why? Stick around and find out. Your hair is strands of keratin which grow out of your scalp. The hair itself is dead, but your scalp is alive. Your hair is moisturized by sebum, which is an oil produced by your scalp. Now, sebum is what makes your hair look greasy, but it's also what lubricates and waterproofs your hair and skin. NOPOO, that's no shampoo, just so we're clear. Advocates will tell you that commercial shampoos are full of detergents.
True.
And that these will strip your hair of its natural oils.
True.
And that will dry out your hair, which either means that your hair will be really dry, or your scalp will overproduce sebum to correct it, and you'll end up with sort of greaseball look. True, depending on whether or not you use conditioner and how often you shampoo and a lot of other factors. So somewhat true. Baking soda, however, is not a better alternative. It's actually worse. The acid mantle which covers your skin and hair is somewhere between pH 4.5 and pH 6.2. About 5.5 generally. Water is neutral at pH 7, and baking soda is alkaline, or basic, at pH 9, and it's a logarithmic scale. But what if you mix baking soda into water? It's still a pH of about 9, which is bad for a couple of reasons. These are the chemical side bonds inside your hair. And the ones we care about are the disulfide bonds. The salt and hydrogen bonds are relatively weak and can be broken by heat or water, hydrogen, or changes in acidity for the salt. But restoring your hair to a cool, dry, pH-balanced state will reform them. If you use straighteners or curling irons, this is how they work. They break the hydrogen bonds in the hair, which reform in the shape of the iron, so flat or curled. Although there are fewer disulfide bonds in the physical bonds, the hydrogen and the salt, they are key to providing your hair with strength and durability. And if your hair has a wave or a curl, the positioning of the disulfide bonds is what is responsible for your curl pattern. Remember that, it'll be important later. It's also obvious from this why pH-balanced products are recommended for your hair, because you don't want to break the salt bonds. Both strong acids and alkalis will break the salt bonds in your hair, so baking soda is down one already because it's a strong alkali and so it's gonna do that. Yeah, but what about those important disulfide bonds? Well, bad news on that too. So let's talk about perms. A perming agent or chemical relaxer is an alkali which can give curly-haired people straight hair or straight-haired people curly hair. How? Well, it's the same stuff either way and it does the same job. It breaks the disulfide bonds in your hair, it disrupts the curl pattern, and it allows you to reset them as straight or wavy or curly or whatever you like, permanently. Lye relaxers range from a pH of 12 to a pH of 14, and no lye relaxers from a pH of 9 to a pH of 11. I mentioned that baking soda was a pH of 9. Yeah, but these things are generally done in salons for a reason, because if you leave them on for too long, you might burn your scalp, or cause your hair to break off, or cause your hair to fall out. Commercial shampoos, for all that detergent can be damaging to your hair if you use it too often, do not generally have this problem because they're pH balanced. So if you've heard of someone who's been using baking soda on their hair and they said, wow, it loosened my curls, this is probably why. It has a pH of 9, so it's gonna break some of your disulfide bonds, which is gonna change your curl pattern, and over time it's also going to damage your hair. Oh, and that sebum, which you're washing with baking soda to preserve, bad news on that too. When you mix baking soda and water and put it on your head, alkaline ester hydrolysis occurs. The sebum on your head is 26% wax esters, which are hydrolyzed and then washed away by the baking soda water mixture. So you're not even keeping that. To conclude, people looking for natural alternatives to shampoo, skip the baking soda. Use it to clean your drains or deodorize your fridge. It's pretty good for both those things. And thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, you can like, share, subscribe, all of that good stuff. You can follow me on Twitter at Jill Bearup. You can donate via PayPal or subscribe to me on Patreon. And you can kick me a message on Tumblr or Twitter or Maven if there is a science/beauty topic that you would like covered. All that said, see you soon.